Hello, hello, welcome everyone. This is No Bullshit Gaming Podcast 2.5 Gamers, session number 47. We're sharing actionable insights, dropping knowledge from our day-to-day user acquisition, game design, and ad monetization jobs. We are definitely not discussing the latest industry news, but we are having so much fun. So let's not forget, this is still 4 a.m. conference discussion vibe. Let's not take it too seriously. Today, we have the whole crew, Felix, ad monetization creative spy, Braberg, Jakub, game design, Christmas tree, Remy R, and myself, Mate, UA plumber, Lancharich. Yeah, our sink broke in the bathroom, and I was actually able to repair it. Fuck me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe changing a job position soon. I hope not. And how are you? Well, I don't care. Honestly, I don't know. Okay.
What are the news, by the way? Like, if we're not talking about them, I'm just curious because I don't think so. There are much news these days. Like, still, like, this kind of a start of the year, nothing's happening, is it?
Yeah, nothing is happening.
Basically. Execs don't start working until mid-January anyway, so, you know, nothing can happen.
Yeah. And we, anyway, like, in the last few episodes and sessions, we didn't talk about like almost any of the news. So anyway, because that, you know, we are sharing the insights from the trenches. And you're moving your camera always, so it's also a fun discussion. So please don't move. Last time it was really annoying, and it was really annoying in the post-production as well, by the way. But okay.
What are we doing today,
Mark? What are we talking about?
Yeah, nice. So I was just about to say we're talking about creative trends. And, you know, Felix is going to talk about this from his perspective. I see some trends that are coming, and I think they're going to be strong in 2023. And also we are going to discuss, or Jakub is going to discuss, how these creative trends can be translated and transformed into the gameplay, actually. Because that's the, you know, important part afterwards.
It's not can be, how they are and how they will evolve.
Ooh, okay, mister, how they evolve.
No bullshit, man. It's of course, like actual examples and references.
Of course. We can jump in right away. Oh, wait, no. We can't, because I want to mention one thing. This is our 1 year anniversary episode. So
is it?
It is.
Happy birthday to us, huh?
Yeah, so on 15th of January, it's going to be a year since we started doing this. So thank you very much for the support. Thanks, guys, for talking no bullshit, actually, for a year. That's kind of an achievement. And yeah, this is 47, and we had 5 interviews. So 52, there you go, 52 weeks. So we didn't miss a week.
That's nice. Solid. Not lazy.
That's pretty solid. Not lazy. Yeah. Nice. Well, it's that's the thing. Since we are doing these day-to-day activities on the UA, game design, and Admon, we have actually a lot of things to discuss. Okay.
All right. Enough
now
bullshit.
Let's dive into the actual meat. Okay.
So, in regards to what Remo was saying last week, that everything is hard, there's actually one thing that's quite easy for ad monetization managers, and that is we have access to all the creatives that are shown in our games. We can also see how many times those creatives have been shown. So I manage quite a lot of video inventory, so I looked back on all the impressions displayed in my games for the last 14 days, and I thought it would be helpful
One second, sorry to interrupt you, because I need to mention this before I forgot it. It's if you don't, like from the UA point of view, if you don't have like access to Sensor Tower, Data AI, Mobile Action, and all these like other tools that can be used for creative research, just talk to your Admon guys. I mean, it's like, that's for free. And I realized yesterday when I was reading the prep, I was like, fuck, like what? Never thought about it from this point of view. You have like access to everything, basically.
Yeah.
And you see it, and you don't. Well, so you
but
guys,
you cannot search in it, can you?
Yes,
if
you can.
If like,
yeah.
But I mean, like, if you're looking for a specific game, if they don't advertise within your inventory, you
then
can't
you
can
see it. No. But yeah. if you have a lot of impressions, sure. Chances are you'll see it, right?
Of course, yeah.
Yeah, but you know, if you don't have money to buy or you know buy these tools,
of course, like you can have your cheap creative search through your Admon guy.
Yeah. Admon guy, and then combine it with Facebook and creative libraries. There you go. Yeah. Okay.
Well, anyway, I thought it would be helpful to talk through the top performing games and the top performing creatives, at least. Like, it gives kind of a micro perspective, because essentially I get to see which creatives are getting the most impressions, which means those creatives are getting the most spend and therefore should have the best results. So in some cases, these creatives that we're going to show now have gotten more than 100,000 impressions in just a few days, which is quite a lot in terms of inventory in just a couple of days. The top advertisers we're going to go through on iOS is Royal Match by Dream Games, Township by Playrix, Merge Mansion by Metacore. And on Android, at the same time, the top advertisers for me was Hero Wars by Nexters, Top War Battle Game by Top War Studios, and of course, always on Android, which is big, is Misplay.
That's actually pretty interesting.
Yeah. I smell fake ads everywhere.
You'll be surprised
from the list.
Like there's a few of these like that went completely like against the wall, fake, like nothing like nice. Is real. But anyway, each of these advertisers have bought at least 1 million or close to 1 million rewarded video impressions in the last 2 weeks, which is like a really like brilliant window into the winning creative strategies, because all these games have shown at least like 15 different creatives in the last 2 weeks, but usually it's one, two, or three creatives that stick out and get like majority of the impressions. So then we're going to talk about these. So in terms of top iOS campaigns, Royal Match by Dream Games I've seen about 1 million impressions in the last 5 days. So as we know, Royal Match is a match 3 title. Dream Games have tested 15 different creatives in the last 10 days. So does that count as like quite a high impression, like turnover, Maché, or not really?
Yeah, that's pretty super interesting high. Number. Yeah.
Yeah. So they have 15 different creatives, and like most of them have quite low impression counts. But then there are 3 creatives that take up about 90% of the impression, and 1 creative that takes up 60% of the impression. So I think Maciej is going to add on this first creative now in the background in post-production. But it's like an homage to everything that Maciej has been talking about in terms of creative production, because it's like you have to link up a rubber tube to kill fire in like another room to save the main protagonist. And it has like these rubbery ASMR sounds when you pull on the rubber tube that you can pull to save the character from burning. And it's like quite satisfying. Yeah, as you can see.
What's the face? Come on, Jakub.
They're like, for everyone that want to see, like, come to YouTube. Maciej will post it into video so you can see it.
Yeah.
And they're pretty much using all the tricks: fake gameplay, rig gameplay, character dying, fire,
ASMR, ASMR.
Everything's there.
You were laughing at me like all the time, and I was talking about the ASMR. Of course, I was talking about ASMR slicing, which is slightly different, but like, you know, there ASMR is kind of like a trend on YouTube, at least for a lot of people.
Yeah. The next best performing creative after that is a kind of a juxtaposition where you see half and half of like cold and hot. Like, so it's like a desert and a winter tundra.
Sorry, Felix. I need to start laughing because he started drinking and the fucking camera just zoomed in on him.
Man, like, I thought we talked about this last episode. Stop it with that app that zooms in.
Like, moving.
So fun. Sorry, Felix.
Anyway, so this creative is... Oops, I clicked on it accidentally. So anyway, this creative, essentially you have to like solve a match 3 puzzle, and in the cold you have to bring down some fire on top of you in the cold tundra, and in the desert you have to bring down water on top of you to basically save the main protagonist. Got a lot of impressions, but it's not performing as good as the ASMR tubes from the first one. The last, yeah, the last creative is very similar to this one where you have to compete between like water release in the desert and the one in the tundra for heat. But it's essentially the same thing, but you have a match three like above yourself in a desert. And essentially to save the main protagonist, the king, you have to solve the match three puzzle. And then essentially you get dumped water and then you survive.
And
looks a bit boring, right? Like,
it is boring, but I see this like save whoever with water in the desert quite often these days.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's like a new concept that is performing well.
You should try it, huh?
Of course.
Yeah,
of course. And you were posting the links, and I said like, "Oh,
I'll put the links in the show notes as well." I'll put the show notes, like all the links in the show notes as well, so you can like have a look at this. So, the next biggest games in terms of impression was Township by Playrix, which of course Playrix, as we know, are the OGs or original gangsters of fake ads. And interestingly enough, they're not really living up to their reputation, right? Like, they're not really doing it in these games. So, like Dream Games, they run about 10 creatives in total. So, that's less than Dream Games in the last 14 days. But there's only two creatives that pretty much take up a majority of these impressions. And the interesting thing here as well, I wanted to ask you about this, Maciej, is like, Playrix, like most of the impressions are coming from Bungle, whereas like Royal Match, like most of them came from AppLovin. So I don't know, like I guess like these companies have their own favorite networks that perform better, and that's how it works, or
exactly, that's exactly how it works. And also like depends on the actual creative concept. This for Township, this is more close to Golden Goblins, the simulation game that we talked about before, and they stole the best performing concept from them.
Yeah, so I guess, seems like it.
Yeah, so it looks like different creative concepts work on different networks as well in this specific case. Yeah. And it's different genre as well.
Yeah. So the top performing creative on Township Playrix, at least what I'm seeing on a micro level, right, from my perspective, is a creative where you essentially collect eggs on your back and you cross a road to get cash to then bet, like, cross the road again and you have to avoid traffic. I've played Township. I didn't see this part at any point in the game, so this is completely like a fake creative.
Nothing like that.
But then interestingly enough, like the second creative is not as fake as the first one. It's kind of like a Sim City looking creative where you have angry emojis.
More fake than the first one. What are you talking about?
No, you actually have a bit of a builder. You have a bit of a builder. Like you have to do that in Township.
Where's the builder?
Like building the elevator?
Oh, yeah, exactly. What the fuck? Come on, man. Like, how did he come up with this? Are you serious?
That's more fake, definitely.
Okay. Have a look on YouTube and make up your own mind. But anyway.
Please tell us in the comments on YouTube, or just send us a message. Like, which of these creatives you think is like
which
more
one
fake?
Is more fake.
More fake.
So now actually moving on to the third game on iOS in terms of most impression, and that was Merge Mansion by Metacore. And these guys served around 750,000 impressions in the last couple of days. And Metacore has only run 7 creatives in that same time period, but 3 creatives have taken up about 30% each. Overall, like the Merge Mansion creatives look so good. Like the branding, it just looks a lot better than any other creative. They juxtaposition a bit of like hot and cold, just like the Royal Match creatives do. But obviously, like Metacore has their signature mystery feel on the creatives. And Metacore is only showing ads through Unity. Interesting. So the first one is a creative of the grandma, the main grandma. She's basically in a hot like place and like laying in a pool. And her daughter calls her from like a really cold place. And basically she looks at the phone and just throws it into the water. And then like, relaxes. And then that's the whole creative. This one is probably the one that has gotten the most impressions. Like it's gotten maybe a couple more percent of the impressions than the other three. But then the second best performing creative by Metacore is basically the main protagonist that you're playing as. She's crying outside a train. The grandma is leaving and they're waving goodbye. And as the train pulls away from the station, she turns around crying And you can see, because she's turned around, that the grandma has actually snuck off the train and runs away from the platform. Sneaky, sneaky. And then actually, like, the third creative, I actually think personally is the best one, but it's gotten the least amount of, like, percentage of the creative. So I think it was about, like, 28 or something like that percent of all the overall impression load. And it's like they're cleaning in a room. And they pull a bit of the wallpaper off, and they find a secret door, and then that's the end of the creative. What's in the secret door? Yeah. Maybe you have to play the game.
I thought that the hand creative always worked the best for me. At least that was the most kind of controversial. If you remember that,
yeah,
one.
It wasn't. I wasn't. Where I didn't find that one. I remember that
by
one.
Police.
Yeah.
Yeah, he grandma lives. Was taken by police, and there was touching through glass, and the hand goes down like "you're next" written on that.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, well, the mystery definitely works.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, but like, yeah, nice. The metacore creative looks so much more like clean and like higher on the brand quality.
They're definitely polished, really polished. I wonder what happened with the Katie Bates creatives.
Yeah, they were running them.
They were even using it for the fucking PR campaigns, right? More than the UA creatives, because I don't know, like, it doesn't make any sense.
Or maybe you are just licensed to run it for some time if you have like.
Depends on the contract. Depends on the contract.
Yeah, that would make sense. Like, why, for instance, P Games is not running Ryan Reynolds anymore.
Well, it sounds and looks like Peak is not running anymore anything, but I'm pretty sure that's not true. But
yeah, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't see it anymore. That's 100%.
Yeah. So speaking of polished, moving on to the opposite, Android. And
come on.
So the clear winner in terms of the most impressions shown from one game on Android is Hero Wars by Nexters. Like, they've shown to close to 800,000 impressions in the last 4 days, and it's one creative here that takes up 90% of the total impressions.
Yeah.
And they've only run 3 creatives in total in my game, so not a lot of creatives, and one creative takes up 90% of these impressions. I can also add that these guys, like, they have gone completely crazy on sexist creatives. And actually, the most creative is actually not a sexist creative. It's actually a dungeon fight where the top performing creative, basically what you're doing is you're running around, the heroes running around in the dungeon, fighting monsters. And then you have to click on the monsters that have a lower level than you. It's like a numeric, it has a number on it. And if you click on the ones with a higher number, then you get attacked. And it's basically you're fighting a spider, you're fighting some knights, and then in the end, you win. And that's the best performing creative. And the interesting thing is, there's the second best performing creative, which is only about 10% of the impression, is the exact same creative. They just add a half-naked girl in the first 3 seconds of the video. And that's the only difference they made between the two creatives.
That's terrible. Yeah. Mm. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yeah, actually, so even the third version these days lately with the dungeon creative, where it actually narrated by a real world porn star. So they're doubling down on the narrative.
Well, she's featured in, I think, on all of those creatives, and it just connected to gameplay. I want to talk about it later on as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. But so then in second place on Android, we have Top War, battle game by Top War Studios. And these guys just 100% fake ads. There's nothing real about this, like not even anything, right? So they have run about 20 creatives. They've run 20 creatives in the last 14 days, which is quite impressive, right? So it's a lot.
Yeah,
but one creative is 60% of those impressions. And it's essentially they've taken or stolen Mathieu's creative idea from 6 months ago, and it's an endless runner where you have to run into different gates, and you have to choose the ones that are lower level than yours. And Mathieu, how does this feel, having a creative stolen?
It's not my idea. Honestly, I was talking about Top War using the hyper casual mechanics in their creatives for some time, and they were. These guys are the OG of using the hyper-casual mechanics in their creatives, actually. And I was inspired by this approach, and I was trying to find like what kind of hyper casual gameplay could potentially fit in the games that I manage. And it was exactly 6 months ago when I was using this endless runner creative concept, and it was performing so fucking well. So fucking well.
It looks like it's performing well as well in my games, because it's got crazy amounts of impressions. So yeah.
Yeah, so I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised that they're running this. And if you look into their these like 20 creatives concepts, and I've written about this a few months ago, because I was looking always at them in regards to the creative concepts and ideas, and they're running almost everything. Like so much of a different concept, so many different concepts at the same time. So I'm not surprised about 20 creatives in the last 14 days.
Yeah,
so I saw sniper creatives, hyper casual creative, merging creatives, like almost like every genre out there, they use it. they pretty much use it.
Yeah, the second best performing creative from these guys, at least in my games, is exactly the same, but it has a different bit of an explosion in the end. And yeah, it's not performing as well, but yeah, it looks a bit more exciting, but I guess the other one performs a lot better. So then I'll move on to the third biggest advertiser, in terms of impression count on Android, and that's Misplay. So Misplay, as we know, it's not a gaming app. It's more of an offerable place where you can earn rewards from
We know that, but not everybody knows that.
Yeah, that's what I'm describing it. Like, yeah, so it's Misplay is like not a game. It's a offerable type of place where you go and you can do tasks like downloading games, and then you get offers or rewards from doing different things. So
that's like very harsh this description, yeah. I would say. It's an app where you can play games and get rewards. And you can actually, because like you can play games and I used Misplay as a UA channel, so that's why I kind of know like their inventory is pretty much engaged players. So you see like really high retention numbers and like kind of like a higher monetization because these players want to play games.
Yeah.
You know, like and as soon as I hear offer wall, then I kind of get defensive.
You don't think it's an offer wall? I mean, in its bare bones, it is, right?
It's much more advanced than an offer wall. It's like offer wall on steroids.
Yeah.
Okay, offer wall on steroids. Anyway.
They're our friends, so.
Okay, so anyway, they have run pretty much two creatives, and it's always the same girl, and these two creatives have shown about equally, so it's 50-50 in terms of the most impressions, and it's kind of the traditional, like, that you see quite a lot on TikTok and YouTube shorts right now, where people are like, it's one person filming themselves from different angles, and they're having a conversation, right? So the top performing or the one of the creatives is essentially one girl is talking to herself about how she can't how complimenting her on how her like wardrobe is so organized and that she bought a bunch of stuff on Amazon to help organize the wardrobe. And then the other one complains that they're too expensive. And then she says she hasn't paid for an Amazon order in a year because she's getting so much paid so much from Misplay. And that's a creative.
Okay. Yeah. Interesting. There's a creative. That's it. Well, UGC content over here. Come on. Yeah. I can imagine if it's working. On the other hand, I was like really, I was looking at these creatives like, what the fuck is happening? I've never downloaded the Misplay thanks to this creative, but that's me.
I guess it works though, because it's like,
Yeah. If they're like the, you know, getting a lot of impressions, I guess it works. Okay. So any takeaways from all of this that you've seen?
I think it was just super interesting because this is the first time I've actually like delved deep into it because like it's not usually what I have spent like my days doing, but it's just you actually see how many creatives these companies that are big are running. Like it really surprises me that it's like 14 plus in just like a week or 10 days. And that's kind of the norm, right? So usually also out of these 14, there's always one or two winners. Yeah, exactly. But it's just, I didn't know it was that much that frequently because it's just, it's a lot of work to create that many video creatives.
It is, but if you're spending millions in a month, then you need to have this type of number of creatives to be able to sustain the either like stable performance or growth eventually. And it's like it's the beginning of the year, so everybody's pushing budgets anyway.
Yeah.
So
I'll leave. I'll leave all the links in the show notes, and then you can just have a look on your own time, and then see which creatives are the best creative strategies currently or in the last 14 days.
Yeah, I will put them somehow in a post-production on the screen so you can enjoy it. If you're listening to this, go to YouTube or just click on the link in the show notes. I think that's the easiest part. So in terms of the creatives, from my point of view, that I was thinking about this for some time or over the Christmas period as well. And from what I see is running at the moment and what was working quite well in 2020. So as you mentioned already, Felix, this is the first trend. And I was talking about this for a long, long time. Last year, I actually made a prediction, woohoo, that this is going to be a trend this year in 2022. And it was.
Maven Mache pats himself on the back again.
Of course. Maven Mache. That's me. That's me all over again. But it was true because I was kind of looking into the data and then made the prediction about it. Anyway, so adapting hyper-casual mechanics and hyper-casual game concepts in games was kind of a big trend in 2022. And I think it's going to continue heavily because, there are still new games on the hyper-casual, in the hyper-casual genre that are still coming out. And this is very very similar to actually running fake ads. You always need to look into new trends and new games that are coming live to be able to adapt these games and ride the wave. And looking at the Topwire example, it's not only them. I actually recently saw the same concept that Felix was talking about for Lord of the Rings: Rise to War. See, even IP can leverage this. It's very true. Yeah, yeah. Oh, look at the zoom. Oh, that was that was amazing. Oh, okay. Now the
who
camera.
Runs that? Who runs that?
I have no idea. I have no idea who is the publisher, but it's a 4X game. It's a 4X game.
NetEase. And of course, NetEase. I thought so.
Ah, there you go. So, they know what's working, and they are not afraid to run whatever.
I would say they have a great licensing contract.
Yeah, maybe. they could fight for using different creatives. So yeah, it's kind of something that works, and even big IPs can do this and leverage it and get great results. But we can see different hyper-casual mechanics or games used in creatives. For example, like Johnny Trigger Action Shooter. I'm pretty sure that you've seen that game before. Or Fill the Fridge. It's kind of used for cooking games as well. Also like Desert Do It Yourself. That was really in the top charts for some time recently. Also very good for cooking games. Well, I was already talking about ASMR slicing last year, so I'm not going to bring it up now. But then there's a Pull the Pin, obviously, but also Tangle Master 3D, which is actually a great game, and it was used for some creatives already multiple times. I will put all the links for the games in the show notes, so everybody knows what's happening. And then we can see Prison Escape games that was used by Hero Wars as well. And also Stickman Run or Stickman fighting against each other. If we, we see all these Stickman fighting against each other and we saw it for Mighty Party before, for different games, obviously fake as well. And also, what about the Save the Dog game? A lot of games use in their creatives and in the core gameplay as well. Well, that's hyper-casual game. There you go. It was a big trend on TikTok. It's a hyper-casual game. And now everybody leverages that in their UA. Honestly, I tried this, Save the Cake concept, which was very close to Save the Dog. It was performing like crazy. Immediately took all the spent, all the impressions, the lowest CPIs I could possibly imagine. Obviously, there's nothing in the game as that, and I saw a lot of
come on, no comments. Bullshit. What were the CPIs?
Well, the regular CPI in the US was like $10. With this one was 2, 5x lower. I mean, it was fucking crazy. But eventually, like the rust wasn't there. At least I didn't run it for a long period of time. If I look into this so now, maybe the rust will be better. But it wasn't worth it because it was a lot of backlash from the actual players that were commenting in the comment section, like, "Hey, this is not how the game looks like." Like, "Oh well, no shit, Sherlock, I know." Okay. So that's like the first trend. Then the second trend I already brought up like a few sessions back, which was the using the altered gameplay. And we could see that from Royal Match, a Rush Royale, and Gold and Goblins examples. So it's not really like as fake as we could see on other creatives or games. This is just using real assets from the game in like a created environment from the game, which is altered, obviously. It's not in the game per se, but it looks like it's in the game.
let me say just that it's completely fake, and then some truth was inserted into the fake.
Well, so you know, how does it work? Yeah, you just take your asset, you create a new level either in your own level editor or you prepared for these purposes. So also, like, this is the fun part. So some companies actually, they have marketing in their minds even before they start working on the game itself. And they count on the fact that actually UA and creatives are going to be like very much integral part of their success. So they prepare tools for marketing teams in advance. So for example, build with dev consoles, level editors for this type of these purposes, to actually easily mix and match the assets so that you can create this type of creatives very easily. And we used it even for Battle Legion, and that was like one of the best performing creatives. So we used this altered gameplay concept where we created a level with, let's say, millions of zombies versus one catapult. And obviously, this is not in the game. Well, it couldn't be in the game, but then like the catapult destroyed all the like 400 zombies, and that was performing the best as we could. So, you know, like, this is something that you can actually use, and it's gonna be one of the trends. And then we have ASMR. no, we don't I already talked about it before. So I would like to talk about maybe just UGC, just user generated content, aka influencer videos, aka using real people in the creatives talking about your game, showing like emotions, misplay, trying to, you know, yeah, like misplay, exactly, yeah, like misplay, trying to persuade the player to install the game, which misplay didn't persuade me to install the app, unfortunately. But it's usually combined with the gameplay. So companies usually combine the influencer or the UGC with gameplay to get better results. And it doesn't need to be necessarily only like influencers. It can be basically any other famous people from, and you can purchase these like videos from Cameo. So this could go like few different directions. So first one, it's like it's gonna suck, Paul, because not every game's creative can be improved by adding a UGC layer or using a UGC concept. Because this is like one recent example. Candy Crush is using this UGC concept. I have no idea like how this could potentially work, but okay, maybe. Well, I will definitely keep an eye on it. This usually works well for mid-core for some reason. And then the other option is like it's going to perform great. So amazing, you can add an additional creative concept to your backlog. Ooh, yay. And then there's the other direction, which we already started talking about with Hero Wars creative. So you don't leverage influencers, but actual actors or even porn stars. Depends on your target audience, obviously. So I used Johnny Sins a few years back in one of the male-oriented games, and it exploded right away. Fucking exploded. Like, everybody was commenting under the creative, like, wow, this is amazing. Wow, Johnny Sins. Okay. For of course, I have never seen Johnny Sins before. I have no idea who is he. But suddenly we found this guy on Cameo, and he's performing super well. And even when we connected him with the gameplay, the numbers even improved. So amazing results. And these days, you know, the concept that Hero Wars creatives are using is just featuring Corey Chase connected to the gameplay. And I had to ask my friends, like, what's her name? Because I didn't know, obviously. I'd never seen her before. But that's like, there's like right now a very interesting overlap between your target audience interests and and your gameplay. So there you go. It can go really wild. And the Royal Match also featured some like B actors from Cameo in their ads last summer from different TV shows. I'm not sure how that went, but it was definitely an interesting concept.
How much do you pay these people? Creatives. Like, how much?
And
do you pay
I paid $500 to Johnny Sins, and I have the license for eternity.
No. $500?
But that's changed. That's changed recently. And you can't use it for eternity, just for a short period of time. I think it's for 1 month, and it's I think it's way more expensive now. So I'm the trendsetter again. There you go.
Last thing I remember, what was it? Like Game of War paid Kate Upton $40 million or something.
But that
like
was
that.
For Super Bowl ad, right?
No, I think that was like.
Oh, well,
like,
they were using
TV
it
ads.
Anyway.
Yeah, it was TV ads.
Yeah.
But they also had John Travolta and
Mobile Target, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yeah, Big Games had Ryan Reynolds and like all these other celebrities. Like, what was the Coin Master have Jennifer Lopez and
Coin Master had almost everybody.
Yeah.
Terry Crews, Kardashians, and whoever else. They even had, when I was looking into Coin Master like geo strategy, they even had like some local influencers or actors from Germany, Austria, and like all of these. Like, it was really interesting. So I mean, I couldn't understand shit what they were talking about in the creative, obviously, but it was nice to see some locally. Like,
yeah, but it was creative. It wasn't just like a Super Bowl ad, like the Clash of Clans example. It was solid creative that was running for months.
I'm not sure if it was solid, but it was running for months.
Yeah, like, I mean, it got reach.
Yeah. They were using in UA for sure in Germany and in these countries, and also I think they had UK related influencers as well or actors. Okay, so one last thing, and which is obviously generative AI, right? This is the trend nobody's talking about because it's fucking
for
new.
Your job.
Yeah. I will be right. I will be without the job in no time.
We'll all be on UBI doing nothing and fishing.
Thanks to AI. Don't worry. You know, the fishing will be done by AI afterwards. Now, like, this is still more as a like experimentational field. As soon as the video generative AI comes out, well, I will be the first to try it out. I mean, it makes a lot of sense. I play a lot with Mid Journey, just, you know, for fun's sake, but also create images for my newsletter as well. But maybe in the form as it is now, the chat GPT and Mid Journey can be integrated into like the creative team workflow to speed up some things. So this is more like a, let's say, trend in terms of saving time and improving workflow for creative teams. So I can already say that it helped me with some creative brainstorming, some notes, identifying player hooks for certain genres and even motivations. And actually helped me like write a creative brief. Obviously, it's not perfect, but it's solid and it can be used for saving time.
Forget the brainstorming and everything. Like, can you imagine like this will work like you know, the current image to image generation? So you feed it all the creatives, all the player access, all the Hero Wars, all the everything, and then generate fake creative with my assets in the same concepts and like thousands of them immediately.
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. Well, I think we are very close to that at some point in maybe even this year. I mean, it's like,
yeah, probably. Like, I've seen that the video generative AI is already there, probably just not out, but it's
yeah, no doubt.
There. Like, I've seen videos done by that.
Of course. And we have I have one last comment, maybe more than a trend. TikTok research, do it frequently. You can find really like golden nuggets there in terms of the trends. So what was research on YouTube in the past? Now it's more like on TikTok because, well, everybody's on TikTok. Everything is happening there. So definitely do this research frequently, and like more often than...
You'll find ants and chips.
Ants and chips, save the dog and whatever else. So yeah, there you go. Okay. Jakub, how to implement these creatives into the gameplay? But very quickly, because, you know, this is boring as fuck.
Of course, my part is always boring.
Fired.
Yeah. So going super fast with these two fakers. The first thing that's been happening from the old days and that's still being happening is this kind of a... I put it into these kind of three very simple categories. The duct tape example, where you blatantly take the creative and put it into the tutorial of the game. Mm-hmm. Hero Wars is running this, I guess, I don't know, probably from time that they got kind of acquired by Playrix or somebody pretty much there and improved the game's performance by like end of 1,000.
I will write about the Hero Wars and the creatives, and I want to take a look at like the timeline. When did they start using this? Because they started with like the good old IQ creatives, then moved
The game was like 3 years old anyway.
So this happened, and I just want to see like if that, like when the Playrix acquisition happened, and like how did that change the whole creative
strategy. Like a better example of this kind of a duct tape example, where you blatantly pretty much put the playable creatives into the tutorial or like first time user experience is Mighty Party,
I love this example.
Yeah, Mighty Party does it a little bit more sophisticated, whereas the UI and the buttons and everything and the flow on the creative seems like it's part of the game. So you kind of think that you are playing the game. It's not really like out of sync, like with the Hero Wars example, where the buttons and everything, they're kind of super cartoony, out of place or with the like game UI and stuff. That would be another very, very good example. Especially great example is the revenue and download chart, where you can see where the game pretty much been out from 2017, like doing okay-ish numbers, and then suddenly they went to like 4.5 million downloads a month and like 8 million in IAP revenue a month suddenly.
Yeah, without changing anything in the game.
Actually. Yeah, without changing much in the game. So there's like this kind of giant spike of revenue that's probably the result of this kind of new creative strategy that's very creative. But yeah, that I would say would be the pinnacle of this kind of a duct tape example. If we move on, there's much more sophisticated trends happening these days, especially in the Forex genres and genres that are very, very heavy on the CPI number. So a good example would be Kingdom Guard, where they pretty much implemented their creatives as part of a new core gameplay. So the game now has, I would say, two core gameplays, or like two games within one game. So the game starts as this kind of innocent, nice merging tower defense game where you easily merge units and there's enemies coming down the line. And like everything looks great and like, oh, there's this nice tower defense thing that I'm going to play from time to time. And then suddenly you're sending units across the map in a 4x full-fledged battle, spending thousands. So that happens around like, I don't know, 40, 30 minutes mark, where the game slowly tries to move you to the other things, as the gameplay in the tower defense core gameplay gets completely automated. You just need to press one button, the towers merge themselves, the towers place themselves, like everything pretty much goes on autopilot, so you don't really need to do anything. And then the currency and everything is in the end like becomes meaningless within the Forex core gameplay, where you actually start by having your town. There's the usual bubble that you're protected for some time from other players, then you get sniped by whales, so on and so forth. We everybody know. That's one thing. And looking at the revenue, it's very, very steady. So this is not some kind of a random strategy that they pretty much discovered along the way. They constructed the game to be done exactly like this. So there would be this kind of a onboarding game that would be very, very easy, very kind of reminiscent of their creatives and like this kind of hyper casual feel. And then slowly they would, but slowly but very smoothly, they would push you to the real meat of the game, which is the Forex game. So that game is faring pretty, pretty well. I think when we were last looking at it, they already crossed like 10 million a month. I guess that's even more now. So we'll see. Another good example where the guys probably took it one notch higher is Top War, where they are actually building multiple of these core gameplays within the game. So in Kingdom Come example, we can see that they have this kind of very, very solid merge tower defense that I think it's like a pretty new game. So I guess they will probably follow the same tactic, but with Top War being kind of a little bit older, they are actually changing their fake tutorial gameplay along the way. So what worked before probably isn't working as good now, so they changed it together with their creatives. So first they had this kind of a merging gameplay where everything were merged and like you were fighting this kind of single player experience on an island, and then slowly they would offset you into the Forex map, the usual. But then later, when they started using this kind of Tetris-like creatives where blocks were merged together and everything, they actually changed the tutorial with it. So you would be now pretty much playing a little bit of Tetris or like merge Tetris on water where you would be merging things. It's actually looking exactly like the creative. And then suddenly, and like
store as well, it's looking
like the creative. It's completely synced. And then like at some point, a chopper flies in and moves you to the island where you actually can complete the rest of the tutorial. So yeah, they had it very, very smoothly done. And I think their last example that when I was looking at it was that they actually implemented even the like the playable fake things into the gameplay. So it's not that duct taped, I would say. So in their new tutorial, you find these kind of strange devices where you need to play these puzzles.
That's the Tangle Master right there.
Yeah, the
Tangle Master right there.
So they saw a trend within hyper casual and implemented it into their tutorial very, very smoothly, because it's not just like, oh, here's a random puzzle, do it. No, the story is actually pretty much based around these weather devices that are blocking the environment with fog, so you cannot see it, you need to build it, fix it, so on and so forth. So it's actually a narrative driving around these hyper casual fake creatives.
Genius.
And it seems it works great for them.
It's great.
So there's like a spectrum of how much you can play with these and like tinker them to your game, from literally duct taping them and not caring about them. Of course, we don't need to talk about Save the Dog X-Hero example, which there's like actual X-Hero games left around tutorial. Yeah.
Also, you have Playrix with mini games. That's the also duct taping everything into the
So Playrix has it differently. Also, Playrix has it run as events. So, for instance, Playrix
in their mini games
in Township.
Yeah,
they have the what's the voodoo most famous game?
Oh yeah, the Helix Jump.
Yeah, the Helix Jump. Yeah, they have actual Helix Jump during an event there.
Oh, that's perfect, man. That's amazing. That's perfect. That's genius. That's really genius.
Yeah, but it's like an event that's pretty much, you know, starts, ends, and it's like normal part of the game that you can play and like earn some currency out of. But yeah, Kingdom Guard and Top War definitely, like, I would say one of the, like, on the tip of the spear regarding this kind of implementation, or let's say synchronization of creatives with your tutorial. Because
also,
that's going to be a trend probably going forward.
Oh yeah, 100%. And we talked about it, I think, in predictions, like how like different game genres should adopt this type of thing. But also, if you think about like Royal Match, they found this drilling creative than like saving the king that is performing well. They implemented it in the game as well. so like, yeah, okay.
They have these kind of like bonus levels or something, I think, based on time. Yeah. And they are somehow reminiscent of their creatives.
Of course, like the best performing creative. And the guys from Golden Goblins, like the developers, they said, well, we are going to implement the best performing creative into the game as well. I mean, it's like, that makes a lot of sense. They just need to think about like how to do it properly. And so it's not like super duct taped. But okay, yeah, I think...
UI designs your games in 2023.
There you go. Yes, finally. Someone said it. Please remember this.
Ego by the time like the 2024 comes along is going to be huge.
No. Don't worry. It's going to be fine. Although, you know, I have all these TikTok swag I look like an fucking influencer now. I need to put like some different backgrounds here. But it's my kids' room, so I guess that's not going to work. Anyway, stop with the bullshit. Thank you very much for coming, listening, watching. I will put all the ads in the post-production, in the video as well, so you can take a look while we talk, and also in the show notes, so you can check it whenever and wherever you are. Please subscribe on YouTube, Spotify, and Apple Podcasts, because it's amazing. Thank you very much. This is like very great support for us. And there is going to be one important gift for you and for us as well. Since this is like first anniversary, I'm going to publish the very first episode on YouTube. So we know like how bad we were and how we are at the moment. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm definitely, well, I need to watch it. I need to watch it. I need to do the post-production. So like, I'm going to be like in a pain for a long time. Anyway, thank you very much. Until next time. Bye-bye.